Blackstone Audio presents Triumphs of Experience, The Men of the Harvard Grant Study, by George E. Vaillant. This book is read by Don Hagen. For Robin Western, who for 20 years has been the linchpin holding the study together. Cast of Protagonists, Decathlon Score. Chapter 1, Adam Newman, 2. Rocket Scientist Who Illustrates Repression and Growing Maturity. Chapter 2. Dr. Godfrey Camille, 5. Lonely Physician Who Spent His Life Finding Love, Lifelong Personality Development, and the Ability to Let Love In. Chapter 3. Art Miller, 0. Elusive High Combat Veteran and Drama Professor Who Found Peace in Australia. Chapter 4. Oliver Holmes, 6. Judge from an idyllic childhood who illustrates its gift to old age. Sam Lovelace, 0. Architect with a miserable childhood who illustrates its lasting curse. Algernon Young, 0. Blue-collar worker from an aristocratic family, an illustration of development derailed. Chapter 5. Charles Boatwright, 6. Optimistic boatyard owner, a model of empathy. Professor Peter Penn, 1. College professor, a man who never quite grew up. Professor George Bancroft, 7. College professor who illustrates the sequential steps to maturity. Dr. Eric Carey, died too young to receive a decathlon score. Polio victim who achieved Ericksonian integrity in the face of an early death. Dr. Carlton Terryton, died too young to receive a decathlon score, a physician who failed to reach career consolidation. Chapter 6. John Adams, 6. A lawyer with 3 divorces and a long, happy 4th marriage. Frederick Chip, 7. A schoolteacher from a warm childhood who created a lifelong, happy family. Dr. Carlton Terryton, died too young to receive a decathlon score. A physician with 4 unhappy marriages. Eben Frost, 7. A mentally healthy lawyer who lacked the gift or desire for intimacy. Chapter 7. Daniel Garrick, 3. An actor, a late bloomer who illustrates the importance to old age of good, subjective, and objective physical health. Alfred Payne, 0. A manager with no ability to let love in. He illustrates aging in the absence of good health. Chapter 8. Dylan Bright, died too young to receive a decathlon score. An English professor gifted in sublimation. Francis DeMille, 2. A businessman. He illustrates personality development from repression and dissociation to maturity. Chapter 9. James O'Neill, died too young to receive a decathlon score. An economics professor who illustrates the destructive power of alcoholic denial. Bill Lohman, a.k.a. Francis Lowell, 2. An aristocratic lawyer who provides simultaneous illustrations of alcoholism as voluntary career and alcoholism as debilitating disease. Chapter 10. Bert Hoover, died too young to receive a decathlon score. A study conservative. Oscar Wilde, died too young to receive a decathlon score. A study liberal. Chapter 11. Professor Ernest Clovis, 3. A French professor who illustrates both sublimation and guardianship. Decathlon score significance. 0 to 1, bottom third. 2 to 3, middle third. 4 to 9, top third. Chapter 1. Maturation makes liars of us all. No man ever steps in the same river twice, for it is not the same river, and he is not the same man. Heraclitus. This book is about how a group of men adapted themselves to life and adapted their lives to themselves. It is also about the Grant Study, now 75 years old, out of which this story came. In it, I will offer tentative answers to some important questions about adult development in general, about the people who engaged us in this experience.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.